गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू मैथ्स क्लास। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू फाइन एंड हेल्दी। इन टुडेस क्लास लेट अस लर्न द चैप्टर नंबर 1, नंबर सिस्टम्स। सो ऑलरेडी यू हैव टेकन द नोट्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। व्हाइल आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू नीड टू गो थ्रू द नोट्स। So, in your earlier classes, you have learned different kinds of numbers. Let's see what is the meaning of number system. What is the number system? Number system means, we'll come to know, it is related to numbers. In your 8th standard, you have learned playing with numbers, whole numbers, integers, like that, isn't it? So, number system means, it is a system containing different kinds of numbers. So what is the first set of numbers? The first set of number is natural number. The first set of number is natural number. It is denoted by n. Can you see the values of natural number? It starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, like that continues. Isn't it? Natural number n is denoted by, natural number is denoted by n. The values of n are all the positive numbers. Suppose along with these numbers, if it includes 0, then the set of numbers is called as whole numbers denoted by W. 0 along with natural numbers are called as whole numbers. 0 along with the positive numbers are called as whole numbers. 0 along with counting numbers are called as whole numbers. Suppose 0, 1, 2, 3, that is, if the set includes minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 or negative numbers, then it is called as integer, denoted by z, integer, z, integer, natural number, whole number, integer. Natural number, positive numbers, whole number, 0 and positive numbers, integers, 0, positive number and negative numbers. Understood? The next set of numbers is rational numbers denoted by Q. What it may be, you might have learned fractions. What is fractions? So, the fractions example is 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 5 by 6, 7 by 8. These are called as fractions. These are called as rational numbers. How it is? It is of the form P by 2. It is of the form P by 2. It is of the form P by Q. So what is the meaning of P and Q? P and Q are values. Minus 1 by 2, it is also a rational number, isn't it? P and Q are the values, either it is positive values or it is negative value. But the condition is, suppose the question is 1 by 0 or 0 by 1, whether it is of the form P by Q, as it looks it is of the form P by Q, but Q should not be 0. Q should not be 0. So it is a rational number because Q is not 0 here. P may be 0. Here Q is equal to 0. So it is not rational numbers. The numbers of the form P by Q are called as rational numbers, where P and Q are taken from the integers, but Q should not be 0. Very important. Q denotes rational numbers. It is of the form P by Q. P and Q are integers. Q should not be 0. So example is, whether 0 is a rational number? Yes, because. How we can write 0? 0 can be written as 0 by 1. Isn't it? It is P by Q. So 0 is a rational number. What about 1? one is a rational number because 1 means 1 by 1, 2 means 2 by 1, 3 means 3 by 1. All the natural numbers are rational numbers. All the natural numbers are rational numbers. So 1 is what? Rational number. What about 2? Rational number. Like this. What about minus 1? It is rational number. Minus 2, it is rational numbers, isn't it? In between 0 and 1, what comes? You might have learned half. Whether half is a rational number? Yes, because it is something called p by 2. The value of p is 1, the value of q is 2, q is not 0, q should not be 0. So 1 by 2 is rational number. 0, 1 by 2, 1. Next is 3 by 2 is a rational number. 2. Next is 5 by 2 is a rational number. And come this side. Minus 1 by 2 is a rational number. Minus 3 by 2 is a rational number. Minus 5 by 2 is a rational number. A number is of the form p by 2 are called as rational numbers. Now we have seen different kinds of numbers. 0. Positive numbers, negative numbers, fractions. Sometimes you will get root numbers. Isn't it? You have a lot, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, root 7, root 8, root 9. Plus I will write root 4 also, root 1 also. What is the value of this? In 8th standard you learnt square roots, square and square roots, as well as cube and cube roots. What is the meaning of root 4? What is the value of root 4? It is 2. Because root 4 can be written as root 2 into root 2. Root 4 can be written as 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4. If it is 2 times, you need to write 1 time. What about 9? Root 3 3's are, instead of 2 times, you can write 1 time 3. 1 now you can write 1 1s are 1. Instead of 2 times we can write 1. Can write root 2 as 2? No. Root 3 as 3? No. Root 4 as 2? Okay. So this is called as what? 2 is what? Rational number. So root 4 is a rational number. Root 1 is a rational number. Root 9 is a rational number. So root 1, root 4, root 9, root 16, these are all rational numbers. Excluding this, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, root 9 are called as irrational numbers. What? Irrational numbers. If need, root 2, minus root 2, root 3, minus root 3, root 5, these are called as what? Irrational numbers. So this is the fifth set of numbers. First set is natural, second is whole, third is integer, fourth is rational, fifth is irrational. Okay, one more set. Fourth is called as real numbers. What is the meaning of real numbers? Rational numbers and irrational numbers together called as real numbers. Rational and irrational together called as rational and irrational together combined are called as what? Real numbers. Real numbers means rational number plus irrational numbers. Rational number means 0, positive numbers, negative numbers, integers, and root numbers. All these set of numbers are called as real numbers. It's called as 6 to 1. Clear? So, whether rational number consists of natural number? Yes. Rational number consists of whole number? Yes. Rational number consists of integer? Yes. Rational number consists of irrational number? No. Whether irrational number consists of rational number? No. Rational number and irrational number together called as what? Real numbers. Whether real number consists of natural number? Yes. Whole number? Yes. Integer? Yes. rational number S, irrational number A. So it is called as real full set of numbers. So after this brief introduction, I'll go ahead with number line. So what is the meaning of number line? Representation of numbers on a line. Representation of numbers on a line. This is called as line. Number line is the word. Representation of integers on a line. This is always 0. This is 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Isn't it? How we can represent the 2 on a number line? Just mark it here. How we can represent 1 by 2 on a number line? 1 by 2 means in between 0 to in between 0 and 1, 1 by 2 comes. So let's like this. This all you learned in 7 and 8. So this called as number line. So how we can represent the rational numbers on a number line? Okay. How to represent 3 by 4? Actually, this is 3 by 4 means only right side is enough. 0. You call this as 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 by 4 means it lies between 0 to 1. Or you can do like this also. If the question is 3 by 4, divide each by 4. This also number line. Where 3 by 4 comes? Here. I'm sure. This all basic to learn already. Now, question arises. Finding rational numbers between two rational numbers. Finding rational numbers between two rational numbers. So can you say the rational numbers between 1 and 3? Yes, obviously rational number between 1 and 3 is, you may say, 2. Isn't it? Can you say rational number between 1 and 2? Yes. In between 1 and 2 you will say 1 by 2. Can you say the rational number between 0 and 1 by 2? Yes, the rational number is 1 by 4. These are very basic. So for the question is, find the rational numbers between 1 and 3. Find the rational number between 1 and 2. Find the rational number between 1 and 0 and 1 by 2. Suppose find 3 rational numbers between 1 and 3. Find 3 rational numbers between 1 and 2. Find 3 rational numbers between 0 and 1 by 2. Then what we can do? We cannot go with these methods. Change the methods. There is only one rational numbers. There is only one rational numbers. There is only one rational numbers between these. Therefore, the question is, find 3, find 4, find 5, find 6 rational numbers. You have to change the methods. How to change the methods? See, find the rational numbers between 1 and 2. Between finding rational numbers between, we need to find 3 numbers. We need to find 3 numbers. 1 and 2, we know only 1 and 2 rational number is 1 and a half. Means 3 by 2. Now it is 1 and 2. Suppose if it is, how we can write 1? 1 can written as 1 by 1. How we can write 2? 2 can written as 2 by 1. Because 2 is a rational number. It's of the power p by 2. Now, if the question is find more than 2, multiply and divide 5 or 10 or 20 or 15. Multiply and divide, what value will the multiply? Same value should multiply here. 2 by 5 by 1 into 5. This can be written as, 5 ones are 5, 1 5s are 5. This is equal to 2 5s are 10, 1 5s are 5. Understood? So for the question is more than 2, multiply and divide 5 or 10. or 15 or 20, any values, both here as well as here. So now look at the answer. 1 can written as 5 by 5, 2 can written as 10 by 5. In between 5 by 5 and 10 by 5, any rest numbers are there? Yes. What is the next number? 6 by 5, 7 by 5, 8 by 5, 9 by 5. These are the rational numbers between these two rational numbers. Because this is 1, this is 2. Isn't it? In between these, how many rational numbers can be seen? When I have multiplied 5, I have seen 4. If I multiply 10, I will get 9 rational numbers. If I multiply 100, I will get 99 rational numbers. If I multiply and divide 1000, I will get 999 rational numbers. So, how many rational numbers are there between each rational numbers? There are infinitely many, very important. There are infinitely many rational numbers between any two rational numbers. There are infinitely many rational numbers between any two rational numbers. Like this, examples I have given in the notes. Try to go through it. Suppose the examples are 1 and 2 is like this. Suppose if it is 1 by 2 and 3 by 2, what do you do? 1 by 2, 3 by 2 can be written as 1 into 2 into 3 by 2 into which one will multiply? 5. Isn't it? That is equal to 1 5 is 5, 5 2 is 10. 3 5s are 15, 2 5s are 10. In between these, 6 by 10, 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10. These are the rational numbers. Here denominators are same. Suppose denominator is different. For example, 1 by 2 and 5 by 3. What we did? 1 by 2 and 5 by 3 they have given. 1 by 2 into 5 by 3 they have given. This many times we did multiplied 5 by 5, 5 by 5, 10 by 10, 10 by 10. If you multiply that with the sum number, we won't get the denominator as same. How we can make it as same? First of all, you have to make the denominator as same. Okay. So if denominators are different, you multiply the denominators interchanging. What is meant interchanging? Here if it is 2 and 3, here you multiply 3, here you multiply 2. Here also when it is divided by 3, here multiply 3. When it divided by 2, multiply divided by 2. Now say look at 1 3 is 3, 2 3 is 6, 5 2 is 10, 3 2 is 6. So it now denominator becomes same. Earlier denominator was different. Nothing but taking LCM of 2 and 3, that is 6. If it is 3 and 4, LCM of 3 and 4 is 12. Like that. If it is 3 and 5, LCM of 3 and 5 is 15. So in between these, how many numbers can be seen? 4 by 6, 5 by 6, 1 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6. There are infinitely many rational numbers. So what is the meaning of irrational numbers? It is a number, it is not of the form p by q. I have given examples, root 2, root 3, root 5. These root numbers are called as irrational numbers. Whether y is irrational? Yes. Very important. The best example for irrational number is pi. Why? Pi is an irrational number. Pi can be written as 22 by 7. You may ask, it is of the form p by q, no? Yes, but the value of pi is 3.1427 dash. It is never ending. Very important word. It is never ending. Usually we will take the value of pi as 3.14. If it is 3.14, it is ending. Actual value of pi won't end, never ending. So it is called as irrational. If it ends rational, if it won't end irrational. Clear? I'll come back with that concept later. Now the question is, representation of irrational numbers on a number line. Representation of irrational numbers. Representation of irrational numbers on a number line. First example is root 2. How we can represent root 2 on a number line? Very important for 2 marks. Number line is all. This is number line. 0, 1, 2. So for the question is root 2. How we can represent? In 8th standard, you have learned again Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem. In a right angle triangle, suppose ABC is a right angle triangle, Pythagoras reflects Pythagoras theorem. Squares on the hypotenuse AC square is equal to sum of the squares on the other two sides, little two sides, AB and BC. This is square. This is the basic of this problem. In a right angle triangle, squares on the hypotenuse means squares on the hypotenuse. AC, what is the meaning of hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is the largest side in a right angle triangle. It is always opposite to 90 degrees. Hypotenuse always opposite to 90 degrees and it is the largest side. So AC square is equal to sum of the squares on the other two sides. Okay? So the question is root 2 means when it becomes root 2. When it becomes root 2, their question, if it is 1 and 1. Okay. Same pictures can be construct here by using the idea of number line. So suppose the question is root 2 is given. How to represent here? From 0 we have to go one step. This is 1 centimeter. We call this as point A. Okay. So you have to draw a line by using ruler, scale, mark each 1 centimeter. If the question is root 2, root 3, root 4, root 5, whatever it may be, first you take 1 centimeter distance and mark this point as A. Understood? Now you take the protractor and keep here, you get 90 degree here. Isn't it? You should measure 90 degree with this point, so you will get one line like this. Understood? Now take a scale and here you measure 1 centimeter. How you measure 1 centimeter here? Same, you measure 1 centimeter here. Understood? This is protractor just for taking a straight line. Protractor is used to get the straight line, perpendicular line. From here 1 centimeter, from here also 1 centimeter. Understood? Draw a line and we call this point as B. This is O or 0. This is A. This is B. Now join this. Exactly this will be root 2. That's all. Exactly that will be root 2. So 1 centimeter gives root 2. 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter gives root 2. That is the meaning. So for the question is, construct or represent root 3, same idea. 0, 1, 2, 1 centimeter you measure, here also you measure 1 centimeter. When you join this, you will get how much? Root 2. Now you have to go ahead with the same procedure. If you want root 3, then from here, this is root 2, keep protractor and measure 90 degree. Earlier, here you measure 90 degree. Now after this step, you have to measure 90 degree here. From here, you have to keep protractor like this. Okay? Again, here mark 1 centimeter. Take 1 centimeter distance. You call this as A, this as B and this as C. Join OC. This will be root 3. And straight, if it is a root of 4, how to construct? They won't ask because it is rational number. Root 4 is rational numbers. If it is root 5, how to construct? Example, 0 number line, 1, 2, you follow the same procedure. From here to here, measure 1 centimeter, call A. Key protractor, again 1 centimeter, B. Join this. This is what? Root 2. So, you keep protractor here, 1 centimeter here. So, each time 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter. When you join this, you get root 3. Like this, you are. If you go ahead, measure 90 degrees in a protractor, you get like this, 1 centimeter, join this. This is root 4 if needed. Then, when you go ahead with this, you get root. Each time 1 centimeter. Procedure is same. When you go like this, same. When you go like this, this is root 3, this is root 4, this is root 5, this is root 6, this is root 7, this is root 8, this is root 9. Go like this. This is called as square root spiral. Very important word. Square root spiral on a number line. Square root spiral on a number line. This will be asked for 2 marks. Very important questions. Okay. Now, real numbers and their decimal expansion. Real numbers and their decimal expansion. Real numbers and their decimal expansion. Let's see what is the meaning of this. So first example is 10 by 3. How to divide 10 by 3? We need to divide 10 by 3. You know, you are familiar with this. 3 how many times? 3 threes are 9. When you subtract, you get 1. Again, whether 1 goes, no, if you put point, it becomes 10. 3, 3 is R. Again, 9, subtract 1. So, each time you get 3, 3, 3, 3, dash, dash. Isn't it? So, 10 by 3 can be written as, how much? 3.333, dash, dash. Second example, they have given it as 7 by 8. This is always a dividend. 7, this is divisor, dividend, divisor, quotient, remainder. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So, a standard learn a statement. So, this is 7, always numerator inside, denominator outside, dividend, divisor. So, this is less than this, so we cannot divide. So it is 0 point, it becomes 17. How many times? 8 is 64. When you subtract, you will get 6. Want to go? 0, 60. 8 sevens are 56. When you subtract, you will get 40. 8 by 7. So exactly times. So 7 by 8 is equal to 0.875. Understood? Third examples, you have to observe these examples clearly. Third examples, it is given that 1 by 7, how to divide 1 by 7, 1 to go, 0 point, it becomes 10, 7, 1 is 7, subtract 3, 30, 7, 4 is 20 each, subtract 20, 7, 2 is 40, subtract 60, 7, 8 is 56, subtract, you get 40. Like this it goes. So, the answer for 1 by 7 is how much? 0.14287. Some values you will get like this it goes. Look at these three examples, this one and this one. In example 1, 10 by 3, we got the value as, example 1, we got the value as 3.333 that means 3.3, what happened? Repeated. Second example, 7 by 8 as 0.875. Whether the values are repeated here? No. Whether the values ended? Yes, it is called as terminated. Values are terminated. It stops. After this, you won't get the decimal. Here you will get the decimal. So it is called as recurring. Here it is not repeating, but it is terminating. Last one, example, we got that 0.142877 dash. Whether the values are repeating, non-recurring, it is called as what? Non-recurring, it is not repeating. Whether it is terminating? No. Non-terminating. Whether it is terminating? No, it is not terminating. Listen carefully here. The important thing is, suppose the value terminates after dividing the given values, if answer ends, if it terminates, then the number is called as rational number. Very important statement. If it terminates, then it is rational number. Second, it is non-terminating but repeats. Non-terminating and repeats, then it is also a rational number. Third one, if it is non-terminating and non-recurring, non-terminating and non-recurring, then it is irrational numbers. Very important. How we can decide whether the given number is rational or irrational? It looks like 1 by 2, as I said, 1 by 3, 5 by 7, 8 by 12, 8 by 11. Several numbers should be given. How to check whether it is rational or irrational? As I said, it is of the form P by Q. It looks P by Q. Sometimes it may be irrational also. How to check? By using this idea. When you divide this number, if the decimal expansion stops, then it is rational number. Sometimes it won't stop but repeats, then it is also rational number. If it won't stop as soon as don't repeat, nothing but non-recurring, then it is called irrational number. Okay, I hope you understood these concepts. Remaining part I will discuss in the next class. Thank you.